listen, gather round. I found something that you can use. Mm-hmm. If you listen round, I'm here to tell you you cannot lose. Oh, a simple song, simple melody, yeah. To remind you that you can be the greatest ever, defeated never. Oh, even though sometimes you may lose, so I.
Welcome to the CISOCAS Engineering Service. Have you ever gone to a supermarket and you discover that the door opens for you automatically? Or you get to a place or a building that is having a fire incident and automatically discover that water starts spraying over the fire? Or you also go, you're traveling along the road and discover that you have to stop for a traffic light and the traffic light was able to control the traffic. All these things are being brought all about as a result of electronic microcontroller, and which is one of it we are going to be teaching you in this training, how you can be able to create this world electronics. And we are going to be teaching you that from the program called Arduino Programming. Arduino Programming is a microcontroller that helps you to control, to put intelligence into hardware. So you can be able to do all those things and many more learning this program, main language. So by the time you come for this training, which we are offering to you, you learn a lot of things you can do with Arduino Programming. Thank you very much. See you at the training.
Make the decision, yeah. You can do all things through your brain. Come on, you're a full team. Yes, you can.
Welcome to the University of Nigeria Nsukka, Department of Mechanical Engineering. So we have a project in front of us that is a drone. So before that, we have to give ourselves an introduction and we go over to the next business. So my name is Oya Kwemeka Steven, a final year student of Mechanical Engineering, popularly called OSHE.
Thank you. Okay, I'm Aishi, I'm Google Rashadman. Okay, this project was submitted to the Department of Mechanical Engineering under a course called Applied Design, ME51. So, we just want to show you some little things about the component, the drone itself. It's called the quadcopter, because actually you can see the arrangement. The cross arrangement with 4 meters.
This is the remote, right? So now we are going to be talking about the components that make up our quadcopter. So we start this way. So this is our remote. So our remote is actually detachable. Okay, we have. So let's just detach it. Okay. So this is Arduino Uno. So this is our microcontroller, the one that. So just like this. So this guy over here is called NRA. Is a NRF, why this is its antenna. So it's actually called plus because of it have ability to transmit data long range. So this is actually a transceiver. So what it does is that right now we place it at this point here. So anything that we are pressing, it transmits the signal through this antenna down to the receiver. So because of this is a remote, so this is what is our transmitter part of it. So we are through with this for now. So the next thing, we'll go over to the drone itself. Okay. For the mother drone itself, so as we all know, this is what a quadcopter. Why it's called a quadcopter? Because of it has 4 rotors, and this configuration is actually a plus configuration. And so we have a propellers, the up propellers, up the up the electric motor. This is a brushless DC brushless motor, and this motor, this Emax, they are very very good because this motor have the ability of rotating.
title of our project is Construction and Design of Atmospheric CO, CH4 and CO2 Measuring Systems. The partial fulfillment of the course, ME340, Measurement and Design and Instrumentation Engineering. Yeah, I'm a good
man. My name is Achiwe Han, I'm the assistant professor.
My name is Oba Emidos, group member. I'm Gresham August.
My name is Richard Mojibu, group member.
I'm my own group leader, I'm one of the group members.
I'm Bozak Omisha Kikechuke, group member.
I'm Duke Raisen Tikena, group member.
Using an Arduino Uno. Advantage of this Arduino Uno system over a temperature controller is that you can actually sense multiple temperatures and use it to control your oven. Two is that you can actually set some parameters, which I will soon show you in this video, like baking time, the oven status, whether the oven is on or off, the current temperatures and the set temperatures. Secondly, when you look at it from the point of view of cost, a Arduino controlled oven is more cheaper when compared to a temperature controller. So I just want to show you how you will be able to wire these things up and get it working. So you can see the current baking time is 2 minutes, the set temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, and the current oven temperature is 75 degrees Celsius. Why it's showing me that the oven is on. So once the temperature reaches above 100 degrees Celsius, the oven status will go off, and that shows that the oven is not on again. You can also see from that circuit breaker, which is the master control for your oven, on or off. So I'm opening the oven now so that you can see it's a little bit heated up now. You can see the heating elements and the thermocouple module over there. Okay, so I will open the circuitry up so that you can see what the stuff was made of. So, what you just need is a relay module. Why in this video I'm using a 4-channel relay module, an Arduino Uno MAX6675, possibly a
AC to DC voltage controller, but for this video I'm using a lithium polymer battery, just two of them to power the Arduino port. But for you to be able to do that, you just have to put an adapter connected to the main AC lines. That is the only additional cost you just have to incur in doing this for your home or for anywhere. Okay, in my next video I'll be showing you the one that doesn't take a preset temperature, that you can actually accept a input from you as a user, so that you can set your temperature at any time, which you'll be using a keypad to do that. Thanks you for watching the video. If you like it, you can subscribe. And for the circuit connections and for the Arduino program that I wrote to be able to generate something like this, you can just comment. I will send it to your email. Thanks very much.
Never know. You don't know sometimes men lose so much.
Have you ever wondered, like, what is the cost of building a model or a prototype for an engineering part, all in the name of mass producing? And you know the cost you use to produce that model, and the cost of, like, okay, correcting and trying to pattern and everything. But with a particular software called SolidWorks, you don't need to build this model. You just need to design it on your laptop. Put the accurate size, the length, the breadth, and even the working condition, the operation, we all on this SolidWorks. And with the aid of this software, you can even be able to correct any part you want to correct. And you can also, like, see how it will look like on the software. And this is what SisaCat Engineering Group is rendering to you: how you can build a 3D software, a 3D drawing on your laptop, and how you can see the working operation, and how you can assemble this machine part all on the software. See you there at the training.
Make a decision, yeah. You can do all things through your brain. Come on, y'all. Yes, you can. But you gotta try.
Friends, you're welcome to this class, an introductory session to MATLAB software. Basically, MATLAB was coined from the word mathematical laboratory. And when you look at the laboratory there, laboratory in the real sense is a place where experimental process is carried out and output in form of data are obtained. And from this data output, we can predict the trend of an experimental process. And here in mathematical laboratory, which the short is MATLAB, we can perform a process using few experimental data to predict future output of an experimental process. And we can also observe the trend of that process having some few experimental results. And with MATLAB, we are now moving to what you can do with MATLAB. In my final year project, I performed a modeling and simulation process on the energy, exergy, and economic analysis of a biomass gasification system. And the result I obtained, we obtained from a master's thesis, which was carried out in Rourkela, India, National Institute of Technology. And the results section, I obtained some of their outputs, which were data obtained from the experiment conducted and the producer gas composition obtained. I plotted different temperatures of the gasifier and different producer gas composition, and with that I was able to generate a curve from which MATLAB gave me the equation of such curve, and at future point you can predict what you are, provided the factors and condition of the gasifier remain constant. And also in MATLAB, you can model a mechanical system, for example, a vibration system. And in that vibration system, having your input, which might be your mass and the spring constant, with your defining equation, defining the relationship between the force exerted on the body and the way the mass moves and vibrates, we can predict the response having our input, and we see the output. And also we can easily optimize and know where we can reduce vibration in the system. That is optimization. By the time we carry out different combination of masses and different spring and spring constant, we can easily predict the particular spring and the spring mass combination that will be used to reduce vibration in the system. That's an aspect of what MATLAB can be used for. Also, MATLAB can be used for automatic control system simulation, whereby we have an antenna and the input response and the corresponding output response is being observed. From the input, we can observe what will be the output response. I believe with all this, you'll be able to learn more as you come for the training. Thank you.
Oh,
song, simple melody, yeah, yeah. To remind you that you can be the greatest ever, defeated never. Oh, even though sometimes you may lose your mind, yes, you can now.
You can do anything if you try.
Oh, dance and gather. I found something that you can use. Mm-hmm. If you listen well, I'm here to tell you you cannot lose. Oh, simple song, simple melody, yeah. To remind you that you can be the greatest.